All right, hey guys, what is up? And welcome back to the YouTube channel, and welcome to the final video, video number 3 of our fuel system series on the second gen project. All right, so we're down here in the shop. We got the truck right here, second gen project, and we have all the parts out here to kind of button up the rest of fuel system. We're gonna be installing our AirDog 5G today. It's a 165 pump. We have all the hardware, we have all the mounting brackets, and then also we're gonna be tying in all of our return lines and kind of going over that. So to start out with, I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all kind of the tank setup right now. It did have a fast on it a long time ago. Was on the truck. There's a draw straw for it. Thinking that we're just gonna leave that in place because it did not have a sump in it. But if you look in here, a long time ago, a beans sump was installed, and this was as I was putting the back half of the truck on. So we already have that installed. Here's our connections for our sump. So yeah, this is kind of the parts table. We'll do a quick little overview of that, and then we will go ahead and start mounting the hardware. So as you can see, this is for a 98 to 0.5 to 0.4 Cummins. We have the lift pump itself. We have the fuel supply line, and then we have all of the quick connect fittings. We have all the hardware for the mounting bracket. We have the mounting cage or cradle, the two plates that sandwich the frame, our draw straw on this unit we're not going to need because we have the sump, and then we have kind of all of our other parts. The one thing we will not be getting into today is the electrical, because there is nothing plugged in on the truck. There is no electrical in terms of where we're sitting at for the project right now. So I'm just going to start, you know, kind of laying this stuff out. Get this cradled in here on the bracket, and then get our two sandwich plates kind of mounted up. I'm not really sure where I'm going to mount the AirDog quite yet. Our beans is all the way back there, so we're going to have to take a look and see exactly where we need to mount this. But we basically have all this frame to work with, so we'll see exactly where we want to go, and we will call it good from there. So I'm going to start getting everything kind of tore apart, and I'll catch up with you once we are ready to mount it. All right, so with that being said, we got one going in right here. We'll just thread that out real quick. It said to use some motor oil on the threads. All right, so I'm just gonna put a tiny bit so that O-ring is good, and I'll spread it out in my hands. All right, so I had to drop the tank real quick, and then to allow us room to go ahead and mount spacer that allows us to get out past these frame mounts. This is where I'm planning on mounting it. I don't think right here is going to work too well, because of if you get any further up here, you're running into a transmission pan and then your cross member and drive shaft. So those are some moving parts you want to stay away from. So right here is kind of the perfect distance in between. And so we're gonna go ahead and get that kind of knocked out. All right, so basically the gist of what we're doing is, if you can imagine the frame being in between here, but this is where the pump will sit right here. So it'll be coming back down. The bottom of the filters will be right here, and then this is where it kind of locks into the front mounting plate. So if you remove this one piece at a time, you have that spacer. So now it's just going to pick a spot on the frame, which we already have, and kind of get everything mocked up, and then we'll see how it fits once we get it mocked up. All right, guys, so new plan. Ended up disregarding the mounting plate just because of how wide a second gen frame is on a single cab truck. I don't have much of the smaller C-channel to work with. So with that being said, went out the old fashioned way. I just drilled 4 holes into the frame, and it will just sit right here on the bracket. I do have the spacer. It does clear the frame mounts. There's not really anything in here to rub the fuel filters. Since it's going to be the bed sitting right here, it's actually going to clear the mounting itself. So I got the pump in my hand. We'll gently drop it down.
right here. All right. And so basically, that's where she's going to sit, right there on the truck. We do have things a little reversed as far as this needing to run that way. Not sure. If I put it on here like this and run it backwards, then our fuel supply line is looking good. But the adjustability for the PSI that it supplies is back against the frame. So not sure if that's the way it needs to run or not. They said to mount it on the inside of the frame. I don't have any room because of it being a single cab truck. The frame basically runs from your transfer case all the way to your axle. You can see it, the fuel tank right here. So, yeah, I need to take a look and see exactly how we need to do this. Okay, so this is the way we're going to have to run it. It's preset to 15 PSI, so I think that's going to be good. I think anything over 18, you start to jeopardize the integrity of the VP44 itself. So we're just going to go ahead and take our mounting hardware and, you know, just drop it bolt for bolt down through these holes and kind of get it all snugged into the mounting bracket. All right, so we got everything tightened down. This is mounted, and so now I am going to work on getting the fuel tank mounted back up. Then we'll go ahead and start measuring, hose and quick connects. This is engine supply. This is inlet from the tank from the sump, and then this is returned to the sump. And everything else coming back off the engine is returned back into the tank through the sending unit. So we'll go ahead and get this tank mounted back up there, and we'll take a look and go from there. All right, just like that. Fuel tank is back on, mounted, sturdy. I got our wiring set right here. And so now, figure out the orientation of the sump under here, which is kind of angled pretty good the way I first installed it. We'll pull back this. We got to get quick connect fittings set in there, dip them in oil, and then we'll have, not really sure, I think this, it doesn't matter on the beans. In terms of where fuel return and fuel supply is. So if this is our inlet, I would think running our inlet, so this is supply to the lift pump, let's just run it to the closest port on our sump, and then our return over here, we can route it back down to it. I'm thinking that's the best way. I need to make sure that it doesn't really matter which is return and supply on our sump. And then we'll start measuring and start cutting hose. So, and then we'll kind of get this back half all buttoned up, and then we'll move our way towards the front of the truck. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and install our quick connects on our fuel sump, and then get all the hose kind of cut to length and start routing fuel line. And then we'll go from there. All right, same thing as last time. We're just going to go ahead and oil the O-ring on the fittings. See a fresh coat of oil. Go ahead and thread these in there. And then these are the same thing, 7/8. There's one. Go ahead and get the other done. All right, and then we will grab our 7/8. Go ahead and torque them down. And they have a pretty hard stop on them, so once you get them snug, they don't really turn much more after that. So there we go. Alright. Those are installed. So now we got quick connect fittings on here, quick connect fitting on there, and then we might run out of them because the air dog kit, it only came with what was supplied. It didn't come with enough quick connect fittings that hook up to here for a sump install, so I may have to get some more because we do have some up here. But without further ado, we will go ahead and start measuring our fuel line, which is right up here. So just to show y'all how this quick connect fitting works, literally all it does is you get it right here and push until you hear a click. And then I'm gonna go ahead and use this one on the inlet to the sump and then run a quick little fuel supply line right here. This 90 looks good. The rest of these need to be straight because they're going to run the length of the frame all the way up there to the engine. So I'm going to get this measured and get another quick connect fitting for that and call it good.
All right, so we got our extra one right here.
And same thing. We're just going to go up here and we are going to push until we hear a firm click right there.
All right. So just like that, we got fuel supply from the sump installed. Quick connect, just push lock and push lock right here. Excuse the parking brake lines. But yeah, we're good on that right there. Good on that. And we'll see how she runs. All right, next thing, we're gonna go ahead and work on running the length from here all the way up to our VP44. And so when you go ahead and get that, this is where our Vulcan big line kit's gonna happen. This is the one that actually screws into the side of the VP44. It doesn't make that hard 90. And so with having this, I was able to use one of the 90s from here back on the pump. So we'll go ahead and get this installed. Brand new crush washer. So we'll get that all buttoned up and I'll show you once what it looks like when we get done. All right, so we have our little adapter. This will go directly into our feed port for the VP44. Right here, get that started. Torque that down. I'm gonna go grab a wrench. You wanna get that snug so we have no leaks. And let's go ahead and use a crescent wrench. All right. That's snug. Actually pretty tight. And then right here is going to be our soft 90. So instead of it being a hard 90 and really going to have that elbow, that U-shape to it. So we're going to have to clear the power steering pump a little bit. But that should be okay. And then that will be kind of where it goes directly from our... It'll go directly from our air dog, those two fittings, directly to our injection pump, our VP44. And then over here, this is going to be our fuel return. Kind of have three parts. You have one coming off the VP, one off the back of the head. You have a T-fitting somewhere right here, and then that T-fitting connects to another fuel return line that follows the frame rail of the truck back into your tank. So I'm going to go ahead and get all this stuff tightened up and then start measuring out the links and how I want to route the fuel line all the way up the frame to our feed port. All right, so basically we got everything kind of mocked up. This is kind of set. We had to allow enough room to get our power steering pump cap off. Routed it down here near the frame. Right here, kind of following it. And then I haven't really figured out how I want to route it. I know it's going to have to go back under the frame. And I left a little bit of lead right here so I can zip tie tight back to the frame. Yeah, thinking about getting all the fuel return just to return in one spot on the fuel neck where you add diesel to. So with that being said, I got to start working up on the engine side, getting all this kind of buttoned up and all the three little return pieces and then seeing how we're going to route it. So on your 98.5 O2 trucks, you have your return lines right here. You have one. This one comes off the back of the head, and it kind of filters, goes into this T right here. And then this one connects to that T this direction right there. And then you have one right here. This is your fitting that returns all the way to your fuel tank. All right, these kind of teed together with this little brass fitting right here. If I want to use fuel line hose, I do have a hard line off the truck, the original one, but there's like three hard lines. I'm just trying to see how I can simplify it with one refuel return line going back to the fuel neck and kind of bypass everything right here as far as what's on your sending unit. You know, just cap these off like this one's capped off right here. Not sure if it's going to work like that, so I'm just going to take a look at it and see where we're at. So with that being said, did have to go ahead and order new rubber grommets for this. The old ones right here, they were getting all boogered up. And so if you don't have a good seal on these, you're going to lose your prime for your engine and your fuel system, and you're going to have hard starts. So I went to, instead of going to Gino's Garage and, you know, $17 for a grommet, I went to Oregon Fuel Supply and got all new crush washers and then all new grommets right here. If you can see it in the bag. And so we can make sure that we don't lose any prime, get a good seal on all the fuel lines. All righty, as you can see, we got them on there. Took a little bit of ump to put them on there, but now we know that we're gonna get a good seal and get everything kind of airtight so we don't lose any of our prime. So now we're gonna go ahead and start getting our new banjo bolts right here. Go ahead and get our banjo bolts with our new crush washers on there. All right, and then here's our banjo bolts. This is the bigger one that goes in the return for your VP. So note that it does go through here. And you're gonna need a crush washer on this side of your banjo fitting, and then also on this side that contacts the VP44. And then your other one, same thing. We're gonna need one. It's the one on the back of the head. This goes to your head, which it, and then this goes to the bolt head. So we need to go ahead and put another one on here. Okay, so we had that hand tighten, how this kind of bends around the back of the head right here. And so now we're going to get our hard line from this port to right here and that T fitting. So everything kind of tie together. All right, easy enough. It'll drop down below your feed port, and then I kind of have it loosely on. And then so see, it's kind of making that 90, and then the T is going to drop back down, and then your return will follow the frame rail of your truck. So this is a good clean install. We're not having to do any of the canister. There's a fuel distribution block that usually goes right there. So kind of here's what we're bypassing to make sure everything looks good. This is what is usually on there. You can see it's blocked off from the previous owner. There's a distribution block over here that stuff kind of bolts to from factory. That sits down here instead. So right now I'm just trying to bypass all that, clean up the engine bay. As simple and as efficient as possible, the T fitting right here, we'll go ahead and get that threaded on there, and then get this one threaded on there and see exactly where everything sits. Tighten it down, and then I believe that we've got a full routed fuel system in terms of fuel supply to our VP, our full supply to our injector lines, to our injectors, and then our return. We just got to figure out kind of the in-between stages on how we're going to route everything back towards or back to the tank. So let me get this all buttoned up and I'll show you what it looks like after. Alrighty, so if we take a look now, you can kind of see everything. We got everything buttoned together, fitted up. So this is the return line off the back of your head going into the T-fitting. This is your return line starting here, coming over or coming under your fuel supply from your VP44, tees into here, and then this is where everything is routed into one single return line. So now it is figuring out the plumbing and how I want to have this feed into one port, which I think is going to be the filler neck on the truck.
All right, hey guys, so we're actually back in the shop. It's a different day, and we had to order some parts to get everything kind of buttoned up on the fuel return line setup. So just got it straight off Amazon, and then we got some 5/16 to 1/2 inch adapters. And so what this is gonna do is this is a 5/16 fitting right here, and then we have quick connect 5/16 too. They are right here. And so I wanted to do everything as quick connects. So if you know we have a fuel line issue, or if we have a leak, or if we wanna change the setup, then we can just go ahead and knock that out and just disconnect super easily. Yeah, go moving forward. We'll go ahead and get everything kind of buttoned up right here, get the quick connect. We're gonna run it. I kind of wanna junction it right here. And then on the filler neck, this is that part that I was referring to. Here's our 1/2 inch. So we'll go from 5/16, basically in a nutshell, that's 5/16 right there. And then it'll just, this will run to the filler neck, and then we'll do that adapter. So I have 5/16 line. I still have leftover 1/2 inch line, fuel line right here.
This shouldn't be too long of you know, a closing of the video and getting everything buttoned up. But from there, we'll get this knocked out and I'll show you what it looks like afterward.
Well, after looking at it closer, I did not realize that this is a 3/8 steel to 1/2 inch nylon. So we actually already had the supplied parts. I just missed that. So if you look under here, we went back right here with a 1/2 inch steel to 1/2 inch nylon or fuel line right here. So we'll be able to use the leftover 1/2 inch line supplied from here, our return, to our return up here on the 90. So This is a clean run right here for the supply, right here, nice and tight. We'll do the same thing for our return.
Looking at it, this one fit right up just as it should, so we're getting there.
All right, so it's simple as that. We got supply to the engine, we got return to the sump, and you can kind of look at the way the lines are in. Clean, nice install to the outside of the frame. I know everyone wants to mount it to the inside of the frame, but with a single cab and the tank, there's literally no spot to run it to the inside. We have the transfer case right here, the skid plate, and then our tank. So we have very limited room when it comes to mounting to the inside. So the outside was the best spot to go. So now we have return and supply right here. And I did read that, at least for beans, your right side is always gonna be your supply and your left side is always gonna be your return. So that will close the fuel system on the pump itself. And then all we gotta do is run this, figure out how far you wanna run 5/16 before we adapt it to our half inch. And then the filler neck on this truck is gonna sit somewhere kind of like right here. So we have to span the gap between the back of the engine to right here. So we have this much left over for half inch, and then I have a whole row or roll of 5/16 right here. So I'll get that all kind of measured out, see where I want to put the junction at, and we'll call it good. All right, so just taking a look at, here's our adapters. So 5/16 to half inch, and then it came with some hose clamps. Probably gonna use it on this because this is brass and you can really tighten down on it. The rest of all the quick connect fittings, they're a little more barbed than this as far as being aggressive. So like right here, you can kind of see the barb sticking out in the half inch line up here. So we don't really need a hose clamp on that, but this right here is not as aggressive. So we'll just go ahead and utilize that and make sure it doesn't leak. So here's where this is gonna go. And then we'll get our half inch line put on this side, clamp them down, and then connect our filler neck fitting. And then we'll kind of just leave it hanging until we get the bed on there and we get the filler neck back toward or back on the tank. So that kind of will wrap everything up. I'll do a little overview video after we get everything kind of tightened down and we'll go from there. All right, so everything is ran now. You can kind of see good clean return line from injection pump, VP44, back of the head. Here's our T, our quick connect 5/16 fitting. I ran it through some zip ties right here. It honestly fits in this kind of little slot, little stock frame mount for what I'm using as a holder for the electrical harness, and then also this smaller fuel line. Here's our supply line. I'm just running through here, and then I just set it on top of the plastic so you can see the connection. So we have it all clamped down, 5/16 to half inch, and then I kind of just left it the length as is. I don't know where it's all going to sit. This is where the filler neck connects to the tank, and then we have it, it's going to sit right here. Or really, it's going to come in at this angle right here. So it's going to go just like that. You can kind of see it from a side view. So that is our fuel system completely ran from the lift pump, from the sump, all the way up to our engine, which is quite the little install. Definitely had, you know, some different parts, not using stock parts, kind of just, you know, matching up fuel lines, fittings, the way that I wanted to do it was bypass. There's a distribution block right here, and then there's also a fuel filter canister right here that I wanted to bypass. So this is basically the cleanest, simplest way to do it, not utilizing any of the extra stock parts that basically you don't need. So that will conclude this video. A lot of different steps, really just kind of did my own way, really ended up just, you know, mounting it straight to the frame right here on the outside, dropped the tank to get to these bolts back here, which honestly probably would not even be able to get to them if we had the tank in here. Might be able to if we ever have to adjust this. And then for the electrical stuff, I will probably just go ahead and run that. It connects here and then it plugs in right here, the stock connector from your stock harness. And then we'll probably just route it the same way up through here, or really down through here, come through the side and run it through these zip ties. And then we'll just let it hang. We kind of have, you know, the big wiring harness hanging right here. We'll let it hang right there because it will connect somewhere up here where the fuse box is around this area. So we'll go ahead and get that ran. Since we're not using any return ports on the sending unit, I bought some little caps. I can go over this port, that port, that open port. And then this was a draw straw. This truck did have a fast on it, but it utilized a draw straw instead of a sump. So cap that. And then this needs to be left open because this is our overflow for the neck for whenever you kind of overflows while you're at the pump. But that'll kind of conclude where we're at. I'll get the electrical ran, cap these off, and then we will be done with the fuel system and fuel side of the truck for now. Alrighty, so that was easy enough. We have ground and then hot for your battery connection. We have our relay right here. And then we also have our last little electrical plug-in, which is this wire. Don't really know where it plugs in. You're gonna have to read the directions on that. And then we have the wire, single wire, which I thought was gonna be two, because that connector up here had the same style that was sticking out of the wiring harness, but had this one ran through the frame rail in between the tank, and that one is plugged in into our pump. So don't really know what this goes to. I'm gonna have to do some research on that. And then we also, as you can see, got everything capped off that we're not gonna utilize on the top of the tank. So basically the sending unit right here is just one electrical plug to get our readout for our fuel level, to make sure that we get good and accurate fuel level to the gauge cluster of the truck. And then this was just, you know, Amazon end caps. Basically only needed three of them, but $9 for 300 of them. You never know when these can come in handy again.
So that rounds out the entire fuel system series. Definitely this one had the most intricate, I guess, parts to it, not really knowing how I wanted to run things on the truck. The other stuff was pretty straightforward. It only fit one way. This, we had a little bit of options on how we wanted to run it, which way we wanted to run it, and what size fuel lines we wanted to go with. But overall, completely happy with the setup. I think it's a really clean setup in terms of usability, efficiency, and you know, being able to access it and just those quick connects. If anything goes wrong with the fuel system, we can, you know, tear it apart real quick, see what's going wrong, and then put it all back together. But, and you can kind of see all the tools it took, all the parts that we didn't use, like the sandwich plate right here. We didn't use the second big line kit because it was not, or big line fitting because it wasn't a CP3 truck. Did not use the draw straw right here. So there's a couple of leftover parts, but you know, that's fine. When you're doing custom builds like this, it's gonna happen like that. I'm completely fine with it. I like the way it's set up. So yeah, if you have any questions, then you know, feel free to comment below. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the video. The next video will include, you know, all the fun stuff on the turbine side. We're gonna get manifold knocked out, intercooling piping, oil feed, oil drain, also our downpipe, and then I need to go ahead and get an exhaust on it. So stay tuned for that. Remember to like and share this video where you talk diesel, Facebook forums, Cummins forum online, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Boss out.